What up, gamers? T.U.G here. This is episode 12 of the Ultimate Let's Play Fire Emblem. And today we're taking on chapter 10, The Distant Plains. I believe this is the final chapter of Lin's storyline. And we're finally going to get our hands on Lundgren and hopefully put him out of his misery, save the nation of Caelin. Let's get going. General Eagler has been defeated. Lin and her band draw ever nearer to Castle Caelin. Within the castle walls, Lin's bitter enemy, Lundgren, awaits. A man who would kill his own kin for a throne. He is the source of all her troubles. He must be stopped. Alright. Time for Chapter 10, The Distant Plains. And not the same distant plains that are in Pikmin. A lot more danger here. Lady Lindis, you should be able to see Castle Caelin once we pass these mountains. Grandfather, I'll be with you soon. Everything rests on this next battle. Lundgren will not be receiving the reinforcements he expected. He'll move against us with everything he has soon. Let him come, let them all come. I will not be turned away, I will see my grandfather. I've come too far to let anyone stand in my way. This is it, Mark. This is our final test. My friends, for one last time, lend me your strength. Alright, so. Everyone's getting involved, Nils included, so no need to pick units, we just gotta place them. Let's just make sure all of our items are in good hands here. I'll go ahead and give vulneraries to Nils just in case. You're okay. I think you'll be fine. Alright. I think that's all we're going to be able to do now. Unfortunately, there's nothing to buy right now. I'm pretty sure there's like an armory and an item shop on the map. As a matter of fact, let's have a look. There's just a village. Maybe we can get something here. Well, here is our armory and vendor. These snags we can actually break down to make bridges if needed. And also to clear a path toward Lundgren here. He's already got a unit in the mountains here, a few swordsmen. Okay, so. So, let's get out of here. And let's get our formation ready. We got a Lancer and a couple of mages up here. So maybe it would be a good idea to put Dorcas and Wallace there. Flank them with, I guess, Lucius. And maybe have Nils along for the ride. My mounted units will be in the back. And maybe I'll have Florina play a little offense over here against these swordsmen. Alright. Wallace is not going to be probably doing a lot of fighting unless he's forced to. But bottom line is there to just basically act as a tank. And again, he'll have everyone else flanking him. And Nils at the ready just in case. So I actually will be using Nils this go around. So I gotta keep him safe. Let's get it on. Alright. Now how far can Nils travel? He can go up to one end of the bridge here. Alright. And we'll have Nils go ahead and give him a second turn so Dorcas can advance a bit. Yeah, he can't reach him. Maybe I should go after that mage first. Actually, I can just kill this guy flat out. careful of who I send out here. Everybody forward here. Can you get the same thing from here, Matthew? Oh no, if I don't bring the laundry now. Oh, hello, are you a soldier? Sounds like a hard life, especially when it rains. Rain must make it difficult for you to move around. I used to ride horses when I was little. I remember how those horses disliked the rain. It's better to be on foot when it's wet. Nomadic horses are trained on the plains to bear with rain, but, well, rain just seems to make it harder for everyone to get around. The weather around here can change in no time at all. I recommend just staying in one place until the rain clears up. So, if there's a chance it may rain, which may mean, maybe a little bit more difficult to, get around. But what I'm gonna do here is I'm gonna bring Lynn a bit further forward here. And plant Lynn there to cross those mountains. And I had a hunch that Durgus would be drawing fire, literally. And Durgus gets just enough for a level up. Let's hope it's a good one. I like it. Now the archers are coming. But we got the, oh, critical hit! We got the distance weapon as well, though I don't know how much more that hand axe can take, to be fully honest with you. These clouds look bad. It's going to rain soon. Let's go, Mark. We should press on while we're still able. Yeah, I went a little further ahead there. Let's see. Unfortunately, you can't get close enough, but maybe with a little bit of egging on from Nils. Nils is actually one play away from leveling up. Let's see. I can take you down, I think. If I can hit you. You missed. Well, that's unfortunate. Maybe I can have Lynn draw some fire here. Let's see what you can do, Lucius. We're gonna get right up in this guy's face. Good work. Again, he's gonna have to fight from a distance here. Actually, you know, maybe I'll hold off on that. Because Sarah needs to get up here and heal up. How far can Sarah go? Up to there. Alright. Durgus, you park it there. We'll let Sarah heal you up. Let's advance our cavalry units, Kent and Sane. You two. Everyone's now bunched up at the northernmost point of the map, except for Lynn, who's crossed the river, hopefully to draw some fire. I don't know if you should be doing that. Yeah, he hit me, but I took no damage. And now it's going to rain, which is going to hamper our movement. Yeah, Lynn can't even get any closer than that. That iron sword's almost kaput as well. Yeah, everyone's being limited here. Okay, well, what can you do? Can't quite kill him. Urk, can you get any closer? No, you can't. You know what, Florina? Face your fear. He won't be able to counterattack if you get right up in his face. Now we'll take this guy down. And his proficiency with the bow increases. Someone needs to be healed up. Will does. So here's what I'm gonna do. Nils, go ahead and play for Sarah. Now we pair the two of them up, we could heal up two guys every turn. That could be beneficial. Too bad I'm only now figuring this out. Nils is gonna level up. I'm only gonna be looking for HP and defense for him, to be fully honest. And you go ahead and heal up Will. Get those extra 5 hit points back. They could make all the difference in this game. And my cavalry units are just limited to basically one square at a time here. Although Wrath may be able to advance a bit further forward. Let's have him visit this house. You're here to fight Lundgren, aren't you? You have enough weapons? Lundgren's no ordinary knight, he's a general. Iron weapons lack the edge to penetrate his armor. If you need something, visit my father's armory. You should go to the shop next door to his, too. They have many powerful weapons and items you can use against Lundgren. Head south and cross the river. You'll see them. Lundgren's a tricky one. He destroyed the bridge. There's an old snag next to the river, though. If you knocked it over, you should be able to cross. Hint, hint. Travel well. You fight for us all. Alright, well, we know what we need to do. We need to get to the southern part of the map and see if we can get to that, armory there. And Lynn's gonna go on the offense here against these guys here. I hope I didn't, let her bite off more than she could chew here, although I could send Florina down as a backup just in case. You know, she gets that bump and luck there. Now she's going up against a bowman. Luckily they can't hit her. Look, the clouds are breaking. This rain should stop soon. One more turn, I think. Go ahead and play for Kent here. Just trying to get some movement here. We're all bunched together. May make things a little difficult. I'll have a Florina at the ready. But again, I gotta be very careful with her, especially when we got a bowman very close by. Go ahead and get that one hit point to Nils here. The thing is, if you gain hit points during a level up, it doesn't refill for you, so. And I'm going to use healing every chance I get. Reason being, she will get experience every time she heals. So for me to not take advantage of that would just be stupid. Alright. Can't move any closer, so I soon I'll be left to with just the Manikati. Good, Lynn was able to take that guy down. This bowman couldn't hit Jack. Couldn't hit the broadside of a barn. Okay, Florina, time to come in and do a little pest control here. And hopefully, Lynn can finish off this archer here. I'm gonna have to go with the Manikati, though. Critical hit! Very nice. Okay. We should probably, ooh, there's a druid down here. Master of dark magic. So we better be careful. get everyone as far as you can here. Does anyone need healing? That's a negative. We can force Kent to move again. Mills is definitely getting his work done here. We're all bunched here across the bridge. Alright. Here comes some reinforcements. They're electing to go after Lynn here. So much for that plan. Not quite enough power. Maybe I can soften him up with Florina. Nah. I was hoping to soften him so I wouldn't have to burn the Mani Kati there, but it looks like I got no choice here. Yeah, it's gonna be, that's the only weapon I have with enough power to take it down in one shot and get a critical hit. We're best case scenario. Alright, Wrath, take this guy out. Might take a little bit of damage, but it's just to clear the road here. Then you can start working on that snag and allow us access to the shops. Wrath's gonna level up here. Now, level 8 Nomad, HP and Strength. Alright. Kent, you may want to go and start helping those guys out. Okay, Nils, go play for Sane here. And he can't quite get to that village yet, but you know what? While he's here, let's go ahead and have him attack that, snag. Not gonna be quite enough to put it away in one shot. Now everyone's gonna kinda spread out a bit. Let's not get all bunched up like we were earlier. Though that may be unavoidable. Not taking a lot of damage, thankfully, although Lynn is really fighting up there. We're soon going to get overwhelmed with his cavaliers here. Yeah, she needs to fall back. She is taking a beating. Too much of one, if you ask me. Lorena, you fall back as well. Can I get to you to Lynn here? Probably not. You go ahead and visit this village. You finally made it here, have you? Such a long way. We're all behind Lady Lindis, all of us. Here, take this. Use it in your battle against Lundgren, please. It's an energy ring. It'll increase your strength and magic power a bit. There are lots of items that augment your abilities. These are hard to come by, so think carefully before you use them. Of course, not using them at all would be a terrible waste as well, right? Items like this might vanish once you use them. Bear that in mind, use them wisely. Okay, go ahead and take down this snag. That's gonna open the road to the other stuff. Now, just out of curiosity, this energy ring increases magic or strength by 2 points. Who do I want to use that on? Maybe Will. Dorcas has got plenty of power as it is. I think I'll just have Sane go down there and start visiting people. You know, you should really visit the armory next door. They've got all you need if you're fighting knights and generals. You need something to defeat Lundgren, right? Once he's been beaten, maybe peace will return to Caelin. Good luck to you. Okay. Well, we got our armory here and our vendor here. And, can't quite get, Sarah to Lynn right there. And more cavalry's coming. These clouds look bad. It's gonna rain soon. Let's go, Mark. We should press on while we're still able. And the rain's threatening again. Okay. I'm gonna go ahead and give that, energy ring to Will. Sarah a little bit closer. I'll have Will use that energy ring next turn. You know, you can start working on that snag. I'm gonna have Matthew raid the stores and then pass out the equipment once he gets his hands on them. Go ahead and heal up Lynn here. That way she can get back in the fray. I don't know if she's going to quite make it to level 10 or not. Gonna attack with a javelin here. Ah, come on, Florina. Can't afford these misses. Let's hoping for a critical here. Luckily, he missed. And that came one attack too late. Alright. And now, you. What do you have? We'll go with the Lance Reaver. He only has 7% chance of hitting me. And even so, if he did hit me, he wouldn't do any damage. Alright. Okay, he's still bringing in his backup. Wow, he actually can make contact with me there. And falls to the Lance Reaver. And here comes the rain. It's begun to rain, but the sky looks mostly clear. This rain won't last long, hopefully for just one turn, I think. Okay, so we'll have Will go ahead and use that energy ring. So now he's got a bit more power. And we'll have Nils play him out. Okay. Alright, so we'll have Matthew go to here. Okay, only got 3,100 to sell. Can't take everything here. The steel bow would be good. Armor Slayer would be good. And the heavy spear. Again, all of these are effective against knights. That's all I can buy, except maybe if I get rid of this iron sword, I can buy a Maybe I should get a heavy spear. And I can give that to one of my cavalry units. In the meantime, Wrath. Trade. Actually, you didn't get a spear, never mind. I'll just go into the vendor and get a few more tomes. Thunder would be nice. If I can get to any of my mages up there. We're on the other side of the river, and I can't quite get across to them right now. Okay. You just move back a bit and finish off that snag. Now the road to Lundgren is clear. Though we need to get our equipment ready here. I don't think anyone needs healing right now. Just stay put there, Sarah. You've already got a hammer. Alright. And here comes a cavalry trying to blockade our progress here. I'll say you missed. Okay, so I need to get all right. Let's just go ahead and pick this guy off. Okay. Now you've got what in your inventory? You got the armor slayer and a heavy spear. Trade you armor slayer for iron sword. I'll give that heavy spear to Kent when I can get to him, because he's gonna need it. Oh, he's got an armor slayer. Never mind. I'll just equip that because we got they're coming through. So saying, you know what? I'll take the heavy spear as well. How far can this guy go? Not far at all. Let's move Will a little closer as well. I didn't get a steel bow, unfortunately. Advancing forward. And frankly, I don't have any more money to spend, so this is going to have to do. Alright. Now, even with this javelin, he's going to be able to do some damage to this guy. Not quite kill him, but still do some serious damage. Alright. Be a good time for healing. Sorry, I'm just trying to get out of my guy's position. I'm sorry I'm not talking a lot. Alright, now it's time for you to play. Because what I would love to really do here is give Lynn the kill shot here. So can you take this guy down? Sure you can. So get in position. Can't hit us from here, so. Alright. And I think he can't call any backup either. Alright. You come on down. Heal up Sane here. I think that's going to give you enough for a level up, too. Yes, it does. Just enough. Well, it's defense, so that's fine. Now, what can you do? A little bit of damage. He's got silver weaponry. And a thunder tome. Unfortunately, he doesn't have enough power to use it. Can I get to Lynn? Yes, I can. Oh, I didn't mean to stop my turn right there. Oh well. Sane, lead the... Sane already has the heavy spear. Apparently I can't use a distance attack with the heavy spear. That's unfortunate. Which means Lynn's just gonna have to go in. Oh, he could kill me in one shot if I were to do that. Okay, what can you do? Nothing. What can you do? Nothing. I may have royally screwed up here. Same, what can you do? Heavy spear. Still need that level of accuracy. Look at that. Okay, Wrath, get Lucius out of the way here. Okay. Luckily, Nils was here, otherwise I wouldn't be able to do this tactic here. This guy's packing a lot more defense than I thought he was. Maybe I should get my mages down here. Unfortunately, Urk's all the way up there. I could potentially bring down Wallace. Okay, so he can't hit me from here, so I'm just gonna end my turn here. He's just gonna stay put. So what can you do? You can use the heavy spear. I may have to use walls to wear him down a bit. Nils is going to get another level up. Just got to stay out of his range, though, at least just for now. You go up here. You get down here. You get out of dodge. You can't heal anybody. Mage's getting ready here. What can Dorcas do, just out of curiosity? Not much. Yeah, this is gonna be a tough bout here. But everyone's in position. He is fully surrounded. It's just a matter of how we attack him. These clouds look bad. It's gonna rain soon. Okay, but hopefully we can get this guy taken care of before the rain falls. You can do some damage here. Actually, before I do anything, what can you do, General, with this heavy spear? Pretty significant damage if he can hit him, that is. Let's go for it. This is my realm you've entered without my permission. You will not leave these lands alive. Aw, Wallace. Well, he missed two. Gotta get Lucius in better position here. Maybe have Urk do a hit and run here. Alright. Although that's really not gonna make much of a difference. Basically just trying to stall us out here. I dare not launch another attack. Hold on, what does he have? He does have a javelin, so I gotta get out of here. Go and heal Wrath. The little he needs of it. Alright. I think we're just gonna stall here for now. Good, he got him. Alright, he got a hit in. Okay. Alright, so this should only last a little while here. Should be able to get a double attack here. Good. As weapon level increased, which is great. Like I said, I want to get Lynn to get the final hit here. You back off. I'm getting you out of the way here. Wallace can take another hit or two here. Alright, I'm just going to stay put. Well, it's possible that he could, if Wallace hits him, then it's game over. For him, at least. Yep. Yeah. Well, it was Wallace who dealt the kill shot instead of Lynn like I wanted, but whatever. That annoying little girl. Nothing but a savage from Sakai. The Caelin throne should be mine. Nope, it ain't gonna be. And Wallace doesn't even get a level up for that. That was kind of a waste, sadly. That's unfortunate. I was really hoping to get Linda to get the revenge shot there, so to speak. Those walls that did the job. Let's get this last little bit of experience. I think there has been some special dialogue where Lynn would have had a bit of a more of a conversation with Lundgren there. Unfortunately, it's not going to happen. So, wasn't meant to be, I guess. Anyway, let's end this. I've stalled enough. Time to seize the castle. We've won. At last I can see my grandfather. You are Lady Linus, are you not? Who are you? I am Reisman, the Chancellor of the Caelin Royal Family. I have received word from Kenton Sane when you first met, but then Lundgren discovered the message and imprisoned me. It is my great pleasure to welcome you to your true home. Thank you. May I see my grandfather now? Yes, of course. Do not be shocked by what you see. Lundgren has been poisoning the Marquess's meals for some time. His body has been ravaged. He's been bedridden for months. Who is there? I said no visitors. I will see no one. What are you doing? Leave me to die. Pardon me. My name is... I'm Lindis. Eh? Did you say Lindis? Is that... My father's name was Hasser, chieftain of the Lorca. My mother was Madeline. I was raised on the plains. Could it be? Come here. Let me see your face. Oh, yes. There is no doubt. You are Madeline's true-born child. Grandfather. Lundgren told me that my daughter had died. My heir, and you too. He told me you were dead. Thank you. Thank you for living. I am blessed. Mother and father were slain last year by brigands. I was the only survivor. I lived on, but... Lindis, please forgive a prideful old man. If I had but accepted your parents' love, there would have been no bandits. We would have lived here together in perfect peace. Grandfather, my parents, my tribe, our life was one of love and peace. The end was tragic, but up until the attack, we were truly happy. Truly? Madeline had a life of happiness? Knowing that gives me so much joy. Thank you, Lindis. I can die in peace now. No, Grandfather, you mustn't say that. There's no avoiding it, Lindis. I've taken too much poison for far, far too long. It's too late. Be brave, Grandfather. You will recover, believe me. On the plains, we say that illness fails in the face of a strong heart. I am with you now. You mustn't give up. You're with me. Yes, we have so much to talk about. Walks to take, music to listen to. There's so much I want to do with you, so much lost time you can recover. That does sound nice, doesn't it? And once you're well, I'll take you to the plains. I'll show you the endless sky, the oceans of grass. I want you to know the lands my mother loved so much. The lands Madeline loved. You're right. I still have quite a bit of living to do. You can do it, Grandfather. Lindis. Lady Lindis, do you honestly plan on remaining here? Tell me truly. Yes, until my grandfather is well. I can't leave him now. I won't. The physician says that Lord Housen looks like a new man. It's like he was never ill. And it's all thanks to you, m'lady. He's the only family I have left. I want to have a long life. Lady Lindis, what is it, Florina? I've been taken into service by House Caelin. From here on, Lynn? I mean, Lady Lindis, we'll be together always. Really? Oh, that pleases me so, but please don't call me Lady Lindis. For you, I'm still just Lynn. My Pegasus and I fly for your house now. I am your servant. There are rules to follow. Florina, I'm happiest when I'm with you. That's more important than how I address you. Please. I suppose I'll just have to get used to it, right? Very well, I understand. Well, thank you. I do love you, Lynn. Oops, I mean, Lady Lindis. Oh, Florina. Lady Lindis, I decided to stay too. Will, weren't you planning on returning home? Well, I was, but I've grown quite fond of Lindis' lesions, you know. I couldn't possibly leave everyone behind. I'll send word to my family regarding my decision. I'm pleased to have you, Will. Thank you, m'lady. Mark, you're leaving, aren't you? No, I'm not asking you to stay. It's just, I'll miss you. When I found you unconscious on the plains, I had no idea we would be together for so long. You helped us so much, and I'm sure you've learned all you can from us. You'll do just fine on your own. I have the utmost faith that you'll be a master tactician, Mark, and a misspelled tactician. That's from someone who's seen you at work. Well then, take care. I hope I see you again. I'm sure that I will someday. Kent, Knight of Lycia. For his bravery in fulfilling his command, Kent is named Knight Commander of Caelin. It is a high honor for one so young, but no one denies his worth. Saint Knight of Lycia. Saint has earned the honor of being named Sub-Commander of the Caelin Knights. Despite his promotion, he still scoffs at authority and woos the village girls. He is much loved by the citizenry. Florina, Pegasus Knight of Ilia. Florina has arranged to stay in Caelin. She spends her every waking hour in rigorous training, hoping to become invaluable to Lynn. Her fear of men is lessened, but only slightly. Will, Archer of Foray. With his cheery outlook and his happy-go-lucky demeanor, Will has become quite dear to Marquess Caelin's household. Kent is teaching him manners befitting a sworn man of Castle Caelin. Dorcas, Fire of Burn. Once Lynn's true heritage is recognized in Caelin, Dorcas returns to his home in Burn. There he cares for his wife and makes a good living as a mercenary fighting the local bandits. Sarah, Cleric of Ostia. Ultimately, Irk succeeds in seeing Sarah safely to Ostia. While her behavior is irritating at best, she is sorely missed. Her acerbic tongue has become legendary. Irk, the Wandering Mage. His contact with Sarah complete, Irk sets off for Etruria. His time as a mercenary is just part of his training, and he's glad to see it end. He has since returned to his mentor. Wrath, the Sakaean Nomad. In the celebration following Lynn's return to Caelin, Wrath slips out unseen. Whether he has returned to Sakaea or has continued to work as a mercenary, no one knows. Matthew, the Enigmatic Thief. Matthew vanishes after the final battle, and his whereabouts remain a mystery. Nils, the Mysterious Musician. Nils and his sister Ninian take their leave of Castle Caelin after a few days. He may well be traveling the land, mastering his musical skills somewhere. Lucius, the Traveling Monk. Lucius studies in Caelin for a time, but he departs after receiving summons to another land. He has since been seen traveling with the Hard-Eyed Mercenary. Wallace, the Caelin General. For Wallace, Lynn's struggle only whets his appetite for battle. He sets off in search of a cause worthy of his blade. He lacks any sense of direction, so it may be years before he returns. Mark, the Tactician. Mark leaves Lynn to continue his training. He plans on traveling throughout Lycia. Lynn refuses to say goodbye, believing in her heart that she will see him again. Now, if you notice the B's, the W's, and the L's, that's battles, wins, and losses. Lynn, the Swordfighter from Sakai. Lynn now lives with her grandfather as Lady Lindis of Castle Caelin. Under her loving care, Lord House recovers, and now the two of them go for many walks in the Caelin Gardens. On clear, dry nights, Lynn can be seen high atop a hill near the castle. Perhaps she is remembering the home of her youth, the plains of Sakai. Yeah, so in case you're wondering what those B's, W's, and L's were, they were battles, wins, and losses. Now, the reason why Dorcas had one loss on his record is because during one of the recording sessions, he actually went down in battle. I discarded the take and just restarted the chapter. That was the only time I had to do that. And unfortunately, it doesn't wipe the loss from his record, unfortunately. So, I'm going to have to be a little bit more careful, or you're going to actually see how many takes it's going to take me to do this. But, I wanted to get through Lynn's story without burning through any save states. Which I did. And again, it's a re-record one time. But this ends Lin's story in Fire Emblem. We're going to be switching gears to basically the main part of the game, the meat of the game. And yeah, the save states are actually going to take effect. I'm probably going to be using them at the start of every turn just to make sure I don't screw up. But basically, the tutorial chapters are done and over with, and we're going to be really getting into the meat and bones of the game starting next episode. So yes, we will save our progress. And we'll call it quits here. Next episode, we begin the true part of the game. Tutorials are done, the training wheels are off, and we're going to continue Fire Emblem. Until then, this is T.U.G saying be smart, be safe, have fun. Later, gamers.